In this section, we will cover Integrated Pest Management, or IPM. IPM is a pest management philosophy that utilizes all suitable pest management techniques and methods to keep pest populations below economically injurious levels. It does not usually rely on only one method or tactic. Often, growers employ a combination of methods to achieve a well-rounded, long-lasting management program. Correct identification of the cause of the problem is going to be critical to IPM. We need to know what the problem is before we can manage it. Incorrect identification can result in the lack of control or environmental contamination. IPM stresses reliance on preventative practices and a combination of different practices. For example, a preventative practice might be to create an environment which insects do not find attractive. By controlling weeds in your plantation, you may also avoid the pressures of some unwanted insects. IPM recognizes that eradication of a pest is seldom necessary or even desirable, and it is generally not even possible. IPM realizes that some pest damage is acceptable. We should focus on economics before we implement management techniques. That is, we should only initiate corrective treatments when the cost of control is less than the amount of damage expected. Why do we practice IPM? It keeps a balanced ecosystem. By identifying the potential pests, we only need to focus on managing it rather than impacting other parts of the ecosystem. Some pesticides can be ineffective. IPM helps reduce risks of resistance development by implementing other management techniques. It is not difficult, but it does require an investment of time and patience. It can promote a healthy environment. It maintains a good public image. People want to know that growers are utilizing other management methods instead of just pesticide applications. And finally, IPM can often, but not always, save us money. Principles of IPM. Correct identification of the pest is important. If you do not know what the pest is, you will be wasting your time and resources trying to manage it. Determining if the pest is a key pest will determine what pest management methods should be utilized. Monitoring and assessing pest numbers and the damage is also important. Asking yourself, are the pest numbers high enough to warrant management? And if yes, determining when the management action would be the most effective. By knowing the pest's life cycles, you can help determine when the pest is most vulnerable to management practices, and if a pest is approaching or at a stage of potential danger to the crop. Preventing pest pressures from the start will be very important as well. Making sure your trees are at their best, low weed pressure, properly fertilized, and most importantly, they're planted in the right place. If management is needed, using a combination of biological, cultural, physical, mechanical, and chemical to manage them. And finally, after an action has been taken, assessing what worked and what didn't. Once you have identified the pest, you can begin planning how to manage it. Determine what management methods are available and benefits and limitations of each. Abiotic factors are natural control measures within the environment that injure or destroy plants and animals, including pests. These controls can be a grower's friend and/or enemy depending on the factor. Some of these factors can be climatic factors, air and water pollution, or topographical features. An example would be heavy rains can wash insect pests off trees. However, it can also cause damage to tree limbs. The most effective and important cultural practice is to observe what is going on every day. Many serious diseases and pests can be halted or slowed early if you know what to look for. Modification of planting, growing, cultivation, and harvesting practices to make the environment less favorable for pests, thus reducing or eliminating them. Examples of cultural controls that can optimize growing conditions for your tree, which we covered in the Getting Started section of this course, include appropriate fertilizers and rates based upon current soil tests. This can give your trees a competitive edge over the weeds, but remember, weeds will also grow faster because of the fertilizer application. Proper planting spacing within rows and between rows, the time of planting, and the variety or plant selection you make. This is necessary so that you choose varieties that are competitive, providing rapid early season growth, as well as selecting varieties that are resistant to disease and insects. The use of machinery and or other tools to control pests is another method of IPM. Mechanical weed control like mowing weeds and hand-picking insects is a great way to eliminate pests without harming yourself or the environment. Traps can also be used to monitor the presence of insects. They are used best to monitor potentially harmful insect levels. They also help growers decide what would be the optimal time to apply controls. For example, the traps used to monitor for balsam gall midge. Physical barriers are used to protect specific plants from pests. Examples include electric fencing to keep deer or other animals out and tree guards to prevent vole damage. Sanitary control includes methods to avoid introducing a pest into a location. Sanitizing tools in bleach, alcohol, or commercial sanitizing agents can prevent the spread of pathogens. Removing infected plant parts or whole plants can reduce disease and insect spread. For example, if you have root rots, you will want to remove the plant and all plant material and avoid replanting in those areas. Cleaning equipment like your pruning tools, mowing equipment, and sprayer equipment is important because it can keep pathogens and especially weeds out of an area. Power washing ATVs, tractors, and trucks before moving from field to field and focusing on the tires can reduce the spread of invasive pests, invasive plants, and soil-borne pathogens. Natural control is an attempt to enhance naturally occurring beneficial organisms. An example is encouraging certain flowering plants near borders which can provide pollen and refuge for predators and parasites of insect pests. Another example is to avoid spraying an insecticide for aphid control unless it is economically necessary, and it is apparent that natural enemies will not control the aphids. By delaying insecticide applications until it is economically necessary, you give natural predators like the lady beetle a chance to control aphids. Biological control. Natural control and biological control are sometimes regarded as similar. However, in the strict sense, biological control refers to the introduction of a predator, parasite, or pathogen to control a pest. Growers are often not aware of these natural enemies and continue to rely on insecticides to control pests. Excessive pesticide use may eliminate natural enemies, further increasing reliance on pesticides. The goal of a good IPM program is to recognize and preserve these biocontrol agents. Even though using biological controls can be time-consuming and expensive, due to the potential staff time to scout and training involved in identification, using them can lead to a reduction of pesticides. Chemical control. It's helpful to keep in mind that IPM does not eliminate the use of chemicals. Rather, IPM puts less weight on their use. Chemical pesticides can destroy habitats for beneficial critters as well as kill off the bad pests. They can also destroy the balance of microorganisms, allowing bad pests to multiply if they are applied too often and incorrectly. Soft or reduced-risk pesticides such as insecticidal soap, ultrafine horticultural oil, and neem products are used for treating outbreaks that happen while managing with biocontrols. When selecting a pesticide, choose the lowest toxicity needed. In summary, using an IPM approach means that you will use multiple tactics to prevent pest buildups. You'll assess the damage before making any decisions, you'll monitor pest populations often, and you'll make informed management decisions that will lead to a reduction in pesticide use.